choosing your battles. Pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on. This is Africa. Zamina, mina, eh, waka, waka, eh, eh. Zamina, mina, sakalewa. This time for Africa. Listen to your God. This is our motto. Your time to shine. Don't wait in line. Vamos por todo. People are raising their expectations. Go on and feed them. This is your moment. No hesitation. Today's your day. Feel it. You pave the way. Believe it. If you get down, get up. Oh, oh. When you get down, get up. Oh, oh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. This time for Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. Waka, waka, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa. For Africa.
Slept at all in days. It's been so long since we've talked, and I have been here many times. I just don't know what I'm doing wrong. What can I do to make you love me? What can I do to make you care? What can I say to make you feel this? What can I do to get you there? There's only so much I can take, and I just gotta let it go.
Thank you.
nothing more to say. And in a funny way, I come. Because the power is not mine, I'm just gonna let it fly.
Keranggupan ayam goreng dengan nasi lemak McD, hanya di McDonald's.
Rainbow. Hey guys, welcome back. Good morning. We're already in week 10. So another peaceful week without any sign of lab test 2 is coming. Okay, but you know it is coming. Most probably we'll do it on week 12. I think right now all of you are quite busy, so I don't want to talk about any of the exam stuff yet. So anyway, if you're a gamer, you know lah, if you have a peaceful week, it's not really a good thing because it is a sign of calm before the storm. And then suddenly everything will come together. So anyway, don't worry, for this data comm subject, you only have one more assessment to go, which is the lab test 2, and then you have 15 more marks more, and then you can go for your FA. Okay, so hold on, let me bring the chat up. So today we are going to go through, finish up the ACL. No, where got new hairstyle? I think you'll be missing for too long. Or are you saying I lost half of my hair volume already? Okay, so today we have two playthroughs to go through together, and we will continue with what we are left off in the previous stream. So previously we have learned about standard ACL, and we are halfway in configuring the standard ACL in example 2. So for those who are going to play through this with me this morning, you can continue with the file that we had on the previous stream, which is the episode 2 of Print Charming. Okay, then in the second half of this stream, we will be learning how to configure the extended ACL, which is the X1 part. Okay, standard ACL, everybody can do it. So if you want to tell people that you're pro, then you have to learn to do extended one. Now for those who want to play the extended one with me, you have to get the third file, which is the new file that I have just put up. So you can also get it from the same place. Look at the description down below on this video, the place that where you get the previous two files, there is one new file has that has been added to the folder, which is the file is called A Day as UTA Admin. So later on I'm going to show you the life of a UTA admin, okay, not GSC admin lah, huh? And then I'll show you what you actually do every day if you are working here as a IT staff here in UTA. Okay. Now another problem here, attendance. If you start the day by asking where is attendance, maybe you have your priority wrong already lah. Attendance, I'll put it up after the stream. Don't worry, you can always come back and sign for the attendance. Important thing is you have to make sure you know how to do this ACL, because again, this will be part of your lab test too. Okay, so I'll jump right in into the place that we have left off the other day. Now, just in case for those who just joined us, if you have missed previous stream, I will have to start over again. Otherwise, it won't make sense to some of you, or even if you have been with me in the previous stream, but you might have forgotten after a weekend, right? So what we have here earlier is, okay, remember the backstory is we have this Prince Charming, which is the prince that has been dating four same princess. And then now what we are doing here is we try to configure standard ACL. So imagine that you are Prince Charming right now. So this router here is the Prince Charming, and then you want to block these four princesses from talking to each other. That's the first thing. The second thing is you want all the princesses still be able to talk to this red color network. Okay, so again, green color, yellow color, pink color, and blue color, they are not supposed to ping each other or anything. Okay. And then all these four networks will be able to ping the PC in the red color network. So that's what we are doing. Now, I'll go through this all over again. For those who didn't finish, I mean some of you left earlier because you had an exam. So I'll go through this again. For those who already know this, just take this as a revision. Okay. Okay, I think I'll just start over, so I'll remove everything here and then I'll show you from the start. You don't have to do anything yet, just let me remove my previous ACL first. Okay, so for the start, if you are new here, then all the PC here should be able to ping each other. So it's still quite dangerous for ping shaming, lah, which is exactly what we want to avoid. So just let me try to ping. So what I'm doing right now is I'm using the Cinderella PC and I'm trying to ping all the other PC on the other network to make sure that I can actually reach them for my gossip session. So yeah, I can still ping all of the princess here. Just let me try this out for all the princess. So next thing, I'm trying to ping to Sleeping Beauty to make sure I can still talk to my Sleeping Beauty friend. Okay, I can ping. And then I want to try one more, the last one. I want to ping to Mulan. From Cinderella, I'm trying to ping to Mulan. So hopefully I can ping. Yeah, everything is working fine. So this is a network without any ACL. And remember that in ACL, you should celebrate when you see people cannot ping. Okay, it's kind of the opposite lah. So but what I'm trying to show you here is if you want to block these four networks from talking to each other, it is a lot of work actually if you are using a blacklist. So in the first example that we had in the Friday stream, I show you how to use a whitelist. And with a whitelist, you simply just write a statement to permit everyone to come here. That's it. Now, this example will be using blacklist, which means that for every network here, you have to do this. So can you see the text here? It means that I need to block green color from going to yellow color. That's the first one. And then I want to block green color from going to the blue color. And I want to block green color from going to the pink color. But green color can still go to the red color. So that's what we are trying to do. And you need one ACL statement each to achieve each of the network that you are trying to block here. Okay, now if you have done with that, it only means you are done with this side. Then you have to think about from yellow color, you have to block the same thing, blocking yellow from going to green, block yellow from going to pink, block yellow from going to blue. Then you are done with this. And then you have to do this for the pink color also. So pink color have to block pink, cannot go to green. Pink cannot go to yellow. Pink cannot go to blue. Then the last one, you need to come here. You need to block blue, cannot go to green. Blue cannot go to yellow. Blue cannot go to pink. So that's actually a lot of work. And I will show you how I do. Depending on whether I have the time or not, I will show you everything, or I'll just show you how I do it from the Cinderella side, okay? So the other day I have already shown you an example on how to block using the host. So I will just do this quickly for those who have already done this. And if you have saved your file the other day, don't do anything, just wait for me, okay? You are in the checkpoint. So after I've done this, I will tell you where is the checkpoint that you should start typing with me, okay? Now for those who just joined, what I'm trying to do now is I want to write the simplest kind of standard ACL to block anyone in the green color network from going to yellow color network. Now, specifically, I want to block this Snow White PC with the IP55.1 and Snow Little PC, the daughter of Snow White, with the IP55.3. So I want to block only these two PC now. Don't worry about these other two PC here, okay? Just don't look at them for now. So you imagine that right now, in the yellow color network, you only have two PC, okay? So I go to this router here, and then I start with ACL1 because this is a standard ACL. And now I'm trying to do a blacklist. Blacklist means I want to block who. And if you are not in the blacklist, you will all be permitted. So I have to do this by using the deny keyword. And followed by who you want to block. Now, there are three ways. I will show you all three ways. We start with the easy one so that I don't scare you off. Okay, now this one is what we have done earlier. You can block one host by one host. So I type deny host, the keyword is the host, followed by the IP address of the host you want to block. So if I want to block piece Snow White, then I will type this, Snow White IP. Press enter. Okay, then you can just press the up arrow key on your keyboard to show the same command that we have just typed in earlier. And then you want to block .3 as well. Okay. Now, if you have done this, it means that right now, green color cannot talk to Snow White and Snow Little. Now, earlier in the previous stream, I have shown you, if I apply this one, okay, I apply this, let me just show you, okay, so the next thing I want to do is, this is the ACL that we have already configured, and it does what we want, okay, that's cool. Next thing, remember to place it, because if you don't place the ACL, it's just simply a rules that is not effective yet. So, you want to go to the interface, the right interface here. Now, in this case, the other day I have already explained why I want to place it in FA00. And also you have a choice of FA01, okay? I don't want to repeat this again. So for those who have missed that, please go back to the previous video. It has already been explained. So just to summarize this, in this example here, I will be placing the ACL here. So I will put this ACL1 here in the out directions, okay? So later on, you will see that I have the ACL here. Now, some of you are doing something like this, ACL1 in. So for those who put ACL1 in, then you have to put it in the FA10, okay? FA10. So again, there are two options here. First one, which is what I will do, is I put the ACL1 here in FA00. Or you can also put in FA10 here, this one here. But you want to put the direction is inside, going inside. And here is going outside, because standard ACL always check the source IP address only. Okay, that is what we have talked about earlier. Now, of course, some of your friends are very smart. Before I tell them, they already know. So you see, if I put your ACL here to block these two PC, okay, so these two PC cannot use. That means these two PC, it is not only that they cannot go to the green color, you know, they cannot go to anywhere. If you think about this, this ACL will block any traffic if he see that the traffic come from 55.1 or 55.3. Okay, so that is what we have designed. We put it here. Then, this one cannot go green color. This is what we want. But this guy here also cannot go to red color, because for Snow White to go to this red color one, okay, to go to red color network here, the source IP is Snow White IP. And when the packet come here, it will be dropped. So some of your friend is very forward thinking. They see few steps ahead of us. So that is correct, which is why it is not recommended that you put your ACL here, because it will block all the traffic from this yellow color network to anywhere. Doesn't matter what you set already. So if you do that, it's better you don't build the network. Save the time, you can have 2 more hours of sleep, right? So which is why I recommend you later to put this ACL1 in this interface FA00 in the out directions. Okay, so going back to the example here, now I'll put in FA00. And then the command is IP access group 1 out. That's it. Now for those who want to see whether the placement is correct, you can use a show run command. If you use a show run, you press spacebar until the interface here. Okay, then you will see this is the IP address. This is the ACL that I just put. Okay, I'll come back to your questions later. I don't want to break the flow, so I will just keep going for now. Now, after I've done this, okay, what we want is Cinderella should not be able to ping Snow White. Okay, so let's see whether this ACL is working. Ping from Cinderella PC, I try to ping Snow White with the IP 55.1. I press enter, and then people can ping or not. Cannot ping. Yeah, that's what we want. So cool. You might think it is cool. Then you see, I try to ping Evil Queen. I'm supposed to ping Evil Queen. I ping Evil Queen. Should be able to ping. Cannot ping. Hey, how come? Why cannot ping one? So something is wrong. You see, when we write this ACL, we just say green color cannot go to yellow color. But now, green color cannot go to anywhere. Okay. The reason is because, like what we have said earlier, there is an implicit deny in the ACL statement. So if you go back to your ACL here, then you go check the ACL, show access list 1, this is the ACL here. If you don't say permit any, it means that you deny these two people there is one more hidden statement that you don't see here. That statement says, deny everyone else. So actually, you are not doing anything. You say, okay, I hate these two people the most. I block them. And the other people that I don't hate, they are also blocked. So this is not correct. So to fix this, you have to go back to ACL1. And then you write permit any. If you do this, and then you check your ACL again, now you have one extra statement here. And this time, it means that you only block these two guys. Other than these two people, everyone, I believe him. Everyone can go through. Everyone can use my network. So that is very important for you when you're setting a blacklist kind of ACL. Okay? So let's try this again. With this in place, of course, I don't have to replace the ACL because it is already there in the right place. So if I try to ping Snow White, of course, I still don't want them to ping. So yeah, this is correct. And then when I ping to Evil Queen, now this one, I should be able to ping. That is exactly what we want. Okay, not exactly all what we want, but we are on the right track. Okay, so this one, the important thing is that you have to remember, always remember to add one more statement, permit any if you are using a blacklist. Okay, now next. What we have achieved so far is that we have already managed to block this Cinderella from talking to Snow White and Snow Little. It's the same for Snow Little, I can show you this as well. Okay, and the way we are doing this is by specifying the IP one by one. So what if one day I want to block more than these two PC? I have another PC, say 55.5 or 55.7, because Cinderella, Snow White's family is very big, ma. Okay, if you have the first child, the second child will come very quickly. Before you know it, you have the third child. So, if you do host by host, there are just too many things for us to set. So next, I'm going to show you how I write a kind of ACL, and we will find out the mask of the ACL just to block these two PC. Okay, again, we are going to learn how to write the ACL using a wildcard mask to block only this PC and this PC using one statement. Okay, that means if later on we apply the ACL, if you have new PC, all those PC will not be blocked. So this one that we are going to do here, it still do the same thing, except that we don't have to type that many time of the command. Okay, so with one line, we can block .1 and .3. Now before you can type, you have to learn how to write this one. Okay, so I'll cut into the visual here, and then I'll show you how you can calculate for the wildcard mask. Okay, so what we want right now is we want to find the wildcard mask and the correct mask that allow us to block only .1 and .3. I don't want to block any other people like accidentally block, okay? So what I do is first I write out the IP that I want to block. So 192.168.55.1. The other IP is 192.168.55.3. So this is the two IP that we are trying to block here. Now the next thing is we want to find the mask that is common to them, the wildcard mask. Okay, so from here you can tell this one here. The first three octet is the same. So we say wildcard mask, if you want to have the exact match, it will be all zero. So in this case here, I will only do for the last octet. We don't want to convert the first three octet. It will be wasting our time. Because these two is the same, to get the same IP here, it has to be zero as the wildcard mask. So for the second octet is also zero. The third octet is the same, is also zero. Now the last octet, we have two different numbers. So now we want to find the common denominator between them. And I have to convert this one to binary first. So 0000 0001. That is the binary value for 1, and then I have 0000011. That is the binary value of 3. Now, the next thing I want to do is, I want to find out what are the differences that I can see here. Okay, which bit here is different? Okay, now, starting from the rightmost bit, you can see that the rightmost bit here, the first rightmost bit, this is 2, 1. So this one is the same. Same means that to get back the same number, the wildcard mask has to be 0. So here it is 0. Then I move to the left, okay? I move left inwards, and then I see the next, the second rightmost bit. This time is 0 and 1, so this is different. So when you see the value is different here, you want to put X here, okay? And then you go on in this way, all the value in front is all the same, so it's all 0, 0, 0, 0. And that will give us the common wildcard mask to block only these two IP. So what you will do next is, let's finish this up. You want to write the full wildcard mask as 0.0.0. So here you just convert this X back to 1. Okay, X convert back to 1, you will get 0.0.0.0.0.1.0. Now if you do a binary to decimal conversion, this one will give you 2. Which means that the common wildcard mask to block these two IP is 0.0.0.2. Okay, so that is how I get the wildcard mask to block these two IP only. Which means that if I have another third IP, that IP will not be blocked by this wildcard mask. Okay, just want to be careful. I don't want to accidentally block the wrong people. So the other thing that you should take note is that when you are doing this wildcard and wildcard mask, when we write the ACL statement, we don't use the network address. Instead, you want to use something we call the base IP. Now, in a short while, I will show you how to calculate the base IP. Not now, because it will be information overload if I do it now. So what I'll do is, I will tell you the base IP is .1. We will just go ahead to configure this one first. And then in the next example, I will show you how I get this base IP. Okay, so what important here is that you know how to get this wildcard mask, how I come up with this 0.0.0.2. If you're okay, then I'll go back to the packet tracer, and right now we want to configure this into the router. So I go back to my router here, and then of course now all the things that we are doing today I'll be doing using the same ACL one. Remember, ACL, there's no right or wrong, so you can always build many ACL for different conditions, or you can have one ACL that take care of everything. So in this example, I'll continue with my ACL one. Now before I do that, we have to remove this condition first. Okay, right now the router already know how to block 55.1 and 55.3. So before I show you the next example, if you want to follow me, you have to remove this thing first, okay? Now, we don't have to remove the placement. Remember, when we say remove, there are two ways. First is, you remove the ACL, means you delete the rules. Who can go in, who cannot go in, you delete. The other kind of delete is you delete the placement. So you have a rules, you place it in different places on the router, in different directions, and right now you want to change the directions, or you want to change the way the place you put this ACL, that one you delete the placement. Now in this example, I'm deleting the whole ACL, but I will keep the placement as it is, okay? So to remove the ACL, I will use the command no ACL followed by the ACL number that you want to delete. So it's ACL1 here. And if you have done so, you can say show ACL. Right now, there is no ACL in this network anymore. So of course the ACL is still placed there, but the root, there is no root. So the router will say, okay, now I have to check, but I have nothing to check. Something like that, okay? So guys, okay so far? Can I know if you're okay? Just let me know on the chat down below, and then before I continue further. So I hope that you are still seeing with me. And right now, I'm going to show you how I configure the same standard ACL to achieve the same thing using a wildcard mask. So I want to build ACL 1. Okay, the same thing, this is a deny because we are trying to block people. And then you want to put 192.168.55.1. Now this one, please be careful here. This time we are not using the network address. If I use the network address, it is 55.0. Here I use 55.1, which is the base IP address for these two PC. Now to make it simple, you can right now you just think of this as I want to block two PC. So this is the first PC that I want to block, 55.1. This is the second PC I want to block, 55.3. So the base IP, you can think of this like the first IP of this set of people is this guy, 55.1. To make it simple, but this is not scientifically correct. In a short, I will show you how you actually find this, okay? Just to answer some of your curiosity, why I use 55.1 is because this one, between 55.1 and 55.3, I have to pick one of their IP as the base IP. Okay, so I go back. Of course, you want to start with a smaller number. So this one is 55.1, followed by the wildcard mask that we have just calculated earlier, which is 0.0.0.2. Press enter, and then don't forget that after that, you have to always put the permit any so that you don't block other people accidentally. And yeah, that's it. That is the same ACL that will do the same thing, except now we only use one line of command to do this. So I don't have to place this ACL again because it is already in the right place. Next, I want to show you whether this is really working. Or come, I can say, if I say so many and then it doesn't work, then I'm just a salesman. Okay, if I say so many and then it really work, then I really know something. Okay, so let's go back to Cinderella PC here. I hope it works. Otherwise, it will turn ugly. And then I want to try to ping 55.1. Luckily, that means now you see it is working. I cannot ping 55.1. Let's try to ping 55.3. Our ACL is supposed to block 1 and 3. And go next. Yeah, luckily cannot. But how do you know I'm not cheating? Maybe it cannot ping anybody else, right? So let me just try to ping 55.2, which is this PC here. Okay? Remember, now you have two extra PC in the yellow color network. The story is maybe you just think Snow White have few other kids outside, but the husband is not Prince Charming. Okay, it's getting messy here. Don't go too far. Okay, so this guy here, we are trying to ping 55.2, which is not supposed to be blocked by the wildcard mask. And let's try to see whether it works. Yeah, luckily. You see, that means right now, when I'm trying to ping 55.2, I get a reply, meaning that the mask that we have just designed earlier is really effective. It is only blocking the people that we want to block, this guy and this guy. Other than that, it will not be blocked. And that is how you block a few PC with a wildcard mask instead of you have to type one command for each of the PC using the host command. Okay, so I'll give you 1 minute to refresh this and to finish up what you are configuring right now if you are following. And then when we come back, I will show you how we can calculate for another extra IP, which is 55.5, this IP here. So in the next example, we have to write an ACL to block also this 55.5. Now, if you get what we are doing here, you can continue and do this on your own. For those who think you need a break after just learning for 20 minutes, go ahead. I'll see you back in 1 minute, and then we go to the next example.
You say what you wanna say.
Hey guys, let me answer you. Welcome back. 1 minute. It's not 10 minutes. Even 1 minute. Hey, you learn for 30 minutes. You rest for 10 minutes. Come on, let's do this. We finish this early, then you can go early. Okay? Now, next, I'm going to show you another example of wild card mask. I hope not too many of you went back to bed. Okay, and before I do that, I want to show you something about ACL. You don't have to do this. I'm just trying to show you how ACL actually works on a router. And there is one important thing that you should know. When we are writing ACL statement, we are writing line by line. So you have one line to do a certain thing, and you have the next line, the next line, the next line. Okay, you can have a very easy ACL where you only have one line, or you have a very big ACL that you have thousands of lines. Okay, so the way router read this is the same. Doesn't matter if it's an easy ACL or a hard ACL, it will read line by line. Meaning that it will go from line 1, line 2, line 3, line 4, all the way until the last line of your ACL. And let's say in between of the lines, you have conflicting routes. So today I say lab test 2 is on this weekend. And then after the end of the stream, I say lab test 2 is on week 12. Or maybe I say lab test 2 is easy. And then tomorrow I say lab test 2 is hard. Okay, then it is conflicting. Now you have a rules like this in ACL. The router will always take the first rule as the to take effect. Allow the first rule to take effect. So if you say block PC1, and then you say unblock PC1 or don't block PC1, then PC1 will be blocked because the router is going line by line. So if you say allow PC1 to go through, and then the next line immediately you say block PC1, then PC1 will go through because router is always reading line by line. And if you have conflicting things like do this, no, do that, no, then router will say, don't care, okay? I don't give something, and then he will only take the first line. So that is how router works. I think everybody should work this way. It will make your life way easier, and you'll be a happier person, okay? So because of that, let's say right now, coming back to the example here, I want to block one new host. Okay, you don't have to really do this. I will just show this to you. So say I want to block this host now. Okay, previously we have already blocked .1 and .3, but now I want to block one extra host, which is 55.2. Okay, now of course naturally my first spider sense will tell me that to block this guy, since it's only one host, I don't want to write any wildcard mask, right? So I'll just go back to the router here, and then I just add one line of command. So router, and then I put ACL access this one, deny host 192.168.55.2. And we know that this statement is correct. This one will block PC2. Just to be safe, let's see whether this statement has been added. And you can actually see yes. So we have three lines here. Right now our ACL sounds like this. First, you'll block these two PC that matches this wildcard mask, which is .1 and .3, and then you will allow anyone else to go through. If it is not these two guy that I don't like, anyone else can go through, and then you block this guy, 55.2. Now, let's go back to Cinderella PC, and then I want to try to ping 55.2, and you guess, do you think we can still ping PC2? So, yeah. The answer is yes, we can still ping. So, something is wrong because we are not supposed to be able to ping PC2 with this ACL. Okay, now if you want to know why, it's exactly what we have just said earlier. The reason is because the router always read line by line. So, when the router blocks the first two hosts and it goes to the second line here to block, to allow everyone else, then you say block. You see, in this statement here, you already said allow anyone else, which also include 55.2, and then you say block this guy. The router will say, no, you already say this, I'm going to do just that. I don't want to change here and change that one. I don't care. Okay, we don't like people like that. This week, lab test one, and then suddenly postpone the lab test, and then postpone again. And on the day on the exam, he postponed again. No people like this. So, which is why you cannot have something like this. So, to have this really work, the solution is really only one way. You have to rebuild the whole ACL. Okay, because here you already say everyone can go through. So actually that's it. You cannot say you want to block anyone. From here onwards, that's it. Everyone will be allowed. Okay, so what I'll do is I will have to remove this ACL. You don't have to do this first. Then to remove the ACL is just simply by typing no ACL 1. And then of course I want to reconfigure back my previous loop, so ACL 1 and then deny 192.168.5.1.0.0.0.2. Now this one here will block .1 and .3, which is what we have done earlier. And then if I want to block one new extra PC .2, then I have to use the command host 192.168.55.2. And this statement will specifically block that PC2 with the IP55.2. And of course you have to remember to always put in permit any. And yeah, that will work. So if you do a show ACL1 here, what we are doing here is really I'm changing the order from this statement, which is in the last line earlier, to the second line here. And if a router, for a router it's very simple. Router is a girl, remember router is a girl. Okay, so always read line by line. Girl is really simple and innocent until she feels something is wrong with her guy. Then girl will overthink. So you read this line, and then you allow everyone else. So you'll block P.1 and .3 here. You'll block .2 here. And then you allow everyone else. So let's go back to Cinderella and try this out. I ping .1. It is not supposed to work. That's correct. .3. Not supposed to ping also. That's correct. And then I ping .2. And this time it should do. Yeah, that's correct. So it's not be able to ping also. So you see what we are doing here is that we have already set an ACL to block this Snow White, Snow Litter, and one extra some kids, some random kids that we don't know where he come from with 55.2. And remember what I'm showing you here is that there is a precedent. So for those who are writing a big ACL and somewhere in the middle you put permit any or you deny any, you have to remember from that onwards, all the ACL is no longer taking effect. So you have to redesign the whole ACL by changing them to the right order. Okay? Now, if you're okay with this, then I'll go on to the next example here. And this time, instead of blocking on these three PC, now just now is what I'm showing you, okay? You don't have to do that. But the next one is the next checkpoint here. So you might want to try this out. We are going to block .1, .3, and .5, this time 3 PC using a wildcard mask, but I don't want to block .2. Okay, so you have to be very careful already because just like anything you do, like you have to be careful with some people. When you say he's like, wow, you look like the Hulk, then some people can think like, okay, you say my muscle is big, some people will say, oh, that means I look ugly. So have to be careful lah. Now here we have to be very careful. I only want to block this one, and this one, but I cannot block this one. And another challenge is that, of course, you know, like I can just write three line of command. I block host.1, host.3, host.5, but now you have to use a wildcard mask. Okay, so of course, the right step would be to calculate the wildcard mask first. Okay, I'll give you 5 minutes to try this out. You go ahead to calculate. No, I give you 2 minutes. 5 minutes is way too long. 2 minutes to calculate what is the wildcard mask that you should use to block this one, and this one, but leaving out this one. So you don't want to have the mask that also accidentally include .2. Okay, that is the challenge here. Now for my side, of course, I have to remove my ACL first. And for you, you should also do the same. You want to remove your current access list one, and then you want to build a new ACL. Okay, now I'll give you 2 minutes to try this out, and then I'll come back and show you how I calculate the wildcard mask and how I configure this. So 2 minutes, huh? Everybody's been there, everybody's been stared down by Hey guys, welcome back. So I'm going to show you how you can calculate the welcome mass. For those who have already got it, congratulations. I think you don't have to worry too much about the FA or even the lab test too if you can do this. Yeah, just my way to give you some positive vibe, but I don't want to lie that much. So let's quickly get back to the example here. Now we have three IP that we are trying to find a common welcome mass that will block or even deny these three IP, okay? It doesn't matter block or deny, this welcome mask is just here to specify a range of addresses. You can use the same welcome mask to permit or deny, that's fine. Now in this case, it will be denied because it's a blacklist. And yeah, the next thing you want to do is you want to count what is the mask for this. So you see the IP is getting bigger, 3 IP, you have 3 IP stacked together like a layer cake. So 3 IP is still okay, manageable. If you have 10 IP, wow, it's a bit hard lah. So never mind, in the exam, I'm also human, you're also human, I won't put 10 IP one. Okay, so let's start with the first octet here. If the octet is the same, the welcome mask will be 0, 0, 0, and we only want to really about the last octet here. So I will convert all these decimal number to their binary. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, this is for 1. Yeah, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. This is for 3. And then you have one more is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay, that is for 5. Just to be sure, I'm not so sure about this. Let me check. In fact, I find a cool trick. For those who think about using Google, you can actually do something like this. You can just, on Google, say decimal 5 to binary. And Google actually understand me better than my girlfriend. He know what I actually want. So yeah, the binary here is 101. So that's correct. And we can go back to this example here. So we'll do the same here. You go starting from the rightmost bit. So this 111. This 3 here is the same. Oops. Now for you to get the same number here, the welcome mask has to be 0, so I will write 0 here, and then we move leftwards to check on the second bit. Now the second bit here, 0, you have 0, you have 1, you have 0, so this one is not the same, so here is an X. Okay, and then you go to the left bit again, see 0, 0, 1, this one again not same, so here is another X. Now you go on in this way, all 0 means all the same, so it's 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So that is how I get the mass here. So to write this back in the decimal notation, you have 0 dot 0 dot 0 dot. Now this one you want to change this 2 to 1, 1. So what is 110 in decimal? Okay, just now I've already calculated this. So over here, 110 is actually, it will give us decimal 6, okay? So over here, we know that our wildcard mask is 6. Now this is our wildcard mask. So later on, when we go back, we'll configure 0.0.0.6 as our ACL mask. But before that, remember we always need to take the base IP, right? Now, in this case, just to make it easy for you, among these three IP here, I will take the smallest value. Oops, hold on. I think just now I covered this. So this one will be the mask that we'll configure later. Remember, the way you do this is just convert all the X here back to 1, 1, and then you just convert this binary back to decimal. Okay? Now, of course, you need a base IP. Now, to make it easy, the way you find base IP is here we got 3. You just take the smallest one. Okay, of course, there will be some example where you don't directly take the smallest one, or that will be out of the scope of this subject. Okay, so in this case, you want to use .1 as the base IP here. So going using this info here, so you already have the base IP and you have the mask. Now we go back to the pay through and then we'll configure this ACL. So now I'm back here. And just to make sure, if you have been following me through this since 8 in the morning, then you want to make sure that right now you want to start new, fresh, and then there is nothing in your ACL, then you go to config T and we'll do something with ACL1. So same thing here, this is a blacklist, so you will use a deny command and then followed by the base IP is 192.168.55.1, and now instead of .2 this time the mask is .6 because we want to block a new IP which is 55.5. So if you do so, that's it. Then you just have to remember to always add permit any, and you should get something like this. Only two lines in my ACL, but I'll be only blocking three people that I really hate, and then the other people, maybe I don't know you that well, so I don't hate you yet, and yeah, that's why you'll be allowed. So only two lines of command here. Now let's see whether this really works. So I go to Cinderella PC, I try to ping .1. This one should not be able to ping, so yeah, we are doing this right. And then let's continue, hopefully. And yeah, .3 also cannot ping, yay. And then one more, we really have to try for 55.5. This is the new guy that has been blocked. And yes, he's also blocked. But always don't celebrate too early. You want to make sure you can still ping .2. And hopefully it is working. Yes, wow, so fast. This is something worth celebrating. So you see, now you have already designed an ACL using a wildcard mask that block only .1, .3, .5, but it doesn't block .2. Okay, now, do you think we get lucky here? Let me ask you a question. Do you think we got lucky here? We have calculated for a mask that will block .1, .3, .5, that's cool. But when we are doing the calculation, do you ever remember we try to avoid .2? Actually, no. Maybe in some way we got lucky, but for those who are interested to know why this works, is because when you use a .6, you are actually blocking all the odd number IP. So you are blocking .1, .3, .5, and .7. So to give you a better picture, let's go back to the visual here. And this is what we got earlier. We are already here. I have to refresh this. And earlier we say that this is our wildcard mask. So we have a mask with 00000XX0. So from here, it's very easy for us to tell what is the IP that is being blocked by this wildcard mask. So there is only 4 IP that is being blocked. What you want to do is you want to try out all the possible combination here. So the first combination would be, I have 2x, right? So I can do something like this. I have 2x are both 0, or I have 1, 0, or the second x is 0, the first is 0, or I have both 1, 1. Okay, so if you really do this one by one, then you're 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and then here you have 0, 0, 0. Okay? Sorry, not 0 here, this is 1. Hold on a minute, this is supposed to be 1. Okay guys, rewind a bit. So this one is a 1 here. Just like the example that I show you when you learn how to calculate the range. Maybe I'll just show you all over again, okay? I don't want you to get confused so early in the morning. So I'll just show you all over again. I have this IP here, 192.168.55.1, and then now we have this mask 0.0.0.6. Okay, let's start over. Now we want to know what is the range of the IP that's currently being blocked. So what we have learned earlier is if you see a mask is 0, then you just write exactly the same number here. So here is 192 for the first octet. The second octet is also the same, 168.55 here, and then now this one here is where you need to do the conversions. So I will convert all this one into its binary, 0000001. Okay, now I will convert the mask into the binary. So convert 6 into binary, you will get 0000. Okay, just to be sure, so it's 110. Okay, so it's 110, so it's a 0 here. Now this one here, the next thing you have to do the match here. So remember, how do we do a match for a wildcard mask? if you have 0 here, then you want to copy back the same value. So here I'll get a 1. If you have x here, you will change. You have 1, you change to x. You have 1, you change to x. And then here it's all 0. Okay? So I will write the full IP here. The IP range that you will get will be something like this. So remember, in a wildcard mask, if you have an x, it means that it can be either a 0 or a 1. Which means that with this IP range, I am able to block or allow the IP if you are 0000001, or the next one is 0011, and then the third IP is 0101, and the last IP is 0111. So this one is the four IP that will take effect by this mask.6, because we know that in the place of x, it can be 1 or 0. So if you convert this one, it's actually .1, .3, .5, .7. So what we learn here is with this IP, the effect that the range of IP that will be affected is this 4 IP here. And you see, in among these 4 IP, .2 is not inside, which is why .2 is not blocked, and all these will be blocked. Okay, so lucky for us lah. Now, if you want to ask me how do I carefully avoid .2, you have to try out a few masks, and then just once you have the mask, you have to really count the range to see whether some of the IP that you are not trying to block is within the range of your wildcard mask. Okay, so in this example, we know that a .6 mask actually help us to block all the odd number IP, .1, .3, .5, .7. Okay, so this will be a better view for you. And yeah, if you understand this one here, I have one more example for you on the standard ACL, and then we'll take a long break. I know this is what you're waiting for, a long break. And when we come back, I will show you how we do the same kind of block and deny using the extended ACL, okay? So let's go back to the example very quickly. I hope you are fine. Let me know in the chat if all these things is clear to you, and then we'll move on to the next one. Hey guys, are you okay? Okay, cool. Now, after the experiment, I found out that the total delay from me to you is about 15 seconds. Okay? Wow, I don't know why. How come we are so far away? I hope you don't feel too far, like, although we are just separated by one mirror. I hope that you feel connected, okay? Now, coming back to the example here, what we have done so far is, okay, we have been trying to play around with this kind of syntax where you know that now you can block people one line at a time using the host command, so one host at a time, or you can also block a few selected people by using a wildcard mask, but that will mean you need to know how to calculate the wildcard mask, or you can just block the whole network. Okay, now in this example here, for the blue color network, I'm going to block the whole network entirely, so I don't care how many people is inside. Okay, so what we want to do is I want to block Cinderella from green color from going to the light blue color and anyone inside the network. So the story is something like that. Mulan is also one of the Prince Charming princess. The only difference with Mulan is that she very know how to make baby. So she, let's say she always make new baby. So you know, milk is expensive. Prince Charming cannot afford to buy rose and buy milk at the same time. So want to block this whole network together. Doesn't matter who is in it. And that means we will be still using a wildcard mask. But this time, I want to block the whole subnet. Now, in this case, you also need to calculate what is the wildcard mask. Okay, now the only difference here is that you will not use a base IP when you are setting the ACL. So let me give you an example here. If I'm Cinderella, I want to stop getting here. I go to the router and... Okay, this time I'm going to build a new ACL. Okay, do I need a new ACL? Let me think. Maybe we don't need a new ACL. Because if we build a new ACL, then you will have to think about where to place this ACL. And it is a bit of a problem because you see, if I build ACL 2 to block this Cinderella from coming to blue color network, green cannot go to blue, then you actually cannot place it here. Okay, this is something that you should know. For ACL, you can only have one ACL in one interface for a direction. So here, ACL1 is already using FA00 out. That means if I have an ACL2, I cannot place it here. Okay, because it has been used. So my other options would be I have to place it here, FA11in, which is a problem because we know if I do a FA11in, it will be actually blocking the blue color network from getting anywhere else. So we really don't have much choice but to put the same ACL here. But since we cannot have two ACL, what I have is I will have to continue with ACL1 here. Okay, but remember, just now you see if I show you my ACL1, sorry. In a way that this ACL will not work as well because we have already said that allow everyone else. So now after that, I say you block blue color here. It is not going to block. Okay, so of course we will have to delete this ACL and then we have to start over again. I know you'll be thinking why we always do that. So if you remember, we say in the first day, ACL is really hard. That is why. That is one of the reasons why. So for this case, I have to remove my ACL first. So no ACL1. And just to make sure that there is really nothing in ACL1, you can do a short ACL1. Then next, you want to add back the rules that we had earlier. So ACL1, deny 192.168. Sorry, 168.55.1, the base IP. And the mask that we got earlier is 0.0.0.6. Now don't add permit any, because if you add permit any here, then you will be just doing the same thing. Next, we want to have another line here using the same ACL1 to block the whole blue color network so that Mulan don't keep adding new baby. So right now I have ACL1 denied. So to block the whole network, what you really need to know is the wildcard mask. You have to know what is the right wildcard mask lah. Now in this case, this is a simple example. Okay, I will show you two examples here. One simple one and then one is where you need to calculate. So this one actually you don't have to calculate because look at here. This is the /24 mask. Meaning that for you to write a /24 mask, you just need to put 0.0.0.255. So over here, this is the network address. Now in this case, just be careful here. I'm taking the network address instead of the base IP, and because I'm blocking the whole network, followed by 0.0.0.255, which is going to block all the hosts in this network. Okay, if you have done this, you can really try this out because the ACL has already been placed. So of course everybody else will be blocked, but that's fine. I just want to make sure that really this is blocked. So I go back to the Cinderella PC here, and I try to ping to Mulan, which is using IP 100.1, and it is not supposed to ping, so hopefully it is not ping. Okay, yeah, this is exactly what you want. Cool. Now, of course, it is not the end yet, we still have to do permit any, but before that, I will go straight to this example here. So the next thing we want to set is also blocking this green color from coming to the pink color. Okay? But this is a bit tricky. The example here is you want to block the whole pink color also, so not just anyone inside the whole network, which means you need to know what is the right wildcard mask to block the whole network. Now in this case, this one here is having a /19 mask, so you know that this is a CIDR, which is not a common mask that we used to see, /8, /16, or /24. So this one, you have to do a bit of the calculation here. And let me show you how. Okay, so first thing is, of course, you need to know what is the one of the IP address of a host in that network. So over here, we are lucky that we know one of the IP here, which is 172.16.144.17/19. So I'm going to use this IP here, 172.16.144.17, to do the calculations, okay? So over here, I have this IP, and next thing is you want to know what is the network address. That's the first thing. Because remember, you need to have the network address as part of the syntax. So over here, 19 means that you have 3 extra bits. So for those who are not familiar, or if you already forget, you know all the IP, we have 4 octet, okay? And then for each octet, you have 8 bits. So over here is a /8/16/24 until the end is /32. Oops, this is blocking you. Okay, now over here, we have a /19 mask. So /19 means that the first two is the first two is I just write in decimal because I don't want to waste time converting this the first two octet. So 255 here. This is the mask. 255 here. Now this is the 19. So from 16 onwards, we need 3 extra bit to /19, which means that I have to convert 144 to the binary number first. Okay, so let's do this together. Again, I go back to, I'm not sure whether this will work, 144 to binary. Well, it is actually working. I think I'm going to support Google from now on. So 144 binary is 1001 0000. So I will convert this one to 1001 0000. Then you have to convert 17 as well. So convert 17 to binary, you will get 1001. So 1 and then 0000. Oops, 30 here, and then you have 1000. So that is 17. Okay, I think this is correct. So we have already converted these two decimal here, and then you want to do, okay, hold on. So what I'm doing here, okay, I don't want to confuse you, so I don't want to write the mask here. This is the IP for, this is the binary for the IP. Now over here, you see, because this is a /19, so actually what we mean is that your network bit will be until here. This is the cutoff point here. Can you see this? So you see this is the 17 bit, the 18 bit, and the 19 bit. So we have a cutoff point here. Okay, so I will erase this thing here so that it won't confuse you. But what you should know is that now all this, the first 19 bit here will be for the network. And for the network, it means what? Set, this one will be 0, 0, 0. Okay? Now from here onwards, you will have all 1. And for a wildcard mask, okay, for a network address, this is all 1. So if you do the conversion here, this one is 111. Now all 0, you have 5 0 here. Now we are calculating for the network address. So here is 0000000. Okay. Now to make this quick, I will just give you the answer directly. This one here, you will get 172.16, and then you convert this one. I think this is the mask. Okay. I'm not sure this is correct. I'll check back in a while. But just to make this quick, I will come back to this. I'm not sure whether this is right. But this is the mask, 16. This is a network address. So this is a network address here. So the next thing is you want to know what is the mask. Okay, so the mask, you just take here and then you put all X here. So X, 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 X. And here is all 0. So you have 8, 0 here, and then you have 8, 0 here. And then you have 0, 0. Now this one, for a mask, change all this to 1. This one to 8 ones, okay? So you have 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. And then you have 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Now you convert this one back, this is 31.255. So that is how you get the mask for this, the sub, the welcome mask for this. Okay? So I'm blocking the view here. So I'm going back to the network here, and I want to configure this 31.255 in. Now for those who are confused about this, actually you don't have to calculate for this because you can just use the Big Cricket calculator. Remember we have learned about this calculator earlier where you can use this one to get the network address for a network which is having a CIDR or a variable mask. Then you will get the 172.16.128.0. Okay, now if my calculation here is confusing, don't worry, because anyway you just use the IP calculator. But the wildcard mask, wildcard mask cannot one, because wildcard mask no calculator. So you have to know how to calculate the wildcard mask, which is you set all the host bit to 1 and then change, you know, one is X lah. So just convert back to binary, you will get 31.255. So if this is confusing, later on after the stream, please come back to this part of the video and then try to replay this. Okay, now continuing from here, next thing here, I want to set the last ACL of the first part here, and we are trying to block green from going to pink. So 172.16.128.0. This is the network address, followed by the mask that we have got earlier, which is 31.255. Okay, now just to recap here, this one here, just use an IP calculator. This one here, you have to calculate. Okay, now it will be really cool if someone here watching today will be able to program a wildcard mask calculator. Do you think you can do that? I don't know, maybe if you are good in C programming, I think you have learned C programming, can try to code a calculator for wildcard mask, and then, I don't know, want to sell it for 99 cents on the app store, that would be really great, because I'm sure some people will buy it when they are taking the final exam for this semester, okay? So anyway, just press enter, and then to finish this up, you have to add the permit, any. And this is the final ACL. Your ACL should show something like this. Now, if you have something like this, that means it is correct. And right now, with this ACL in place, it is going to block this guy from going to anyone in, this guy here, dot 1, dot 3, and dot 5 here. And also, he will block from green color to anyone in the blue color, and it will also block green color to anyone in the pink color. Now of course this is not the end. What I have shown you here is I have already achieved this part here, but think about this. This is going to be a problem for Prince Charming still, because the other princesses will still be able to talk to each other. Now if you are, I don't want to say you are free, nobody is free in this world. If you have the time, maybe during the weekend, you can continue this example here on your own. Try to write ACL2, and the ACL2 should do this, and then write ACL3 to do this, write ACL4 to do this, and place them on the right interface so that in the end, no one in this green, pink, blue, yellow network can talk to each other, but all of them should be able to go to the red color network. That is what maybe I call this a homework. Okay, then you have to do it. So this is one example of how we set ACL. And of course, there's another thing that you should take note is that later on, when you're trying to do ACL2, ACL3, and ACL4, it's actually way simpler because you see, in ACL2, you don't really have to write this line anymore because this line has already been in place, but been enforced when you do this. Do you see that? So in ACL 2, you really only need to set this one and this one. Now, after that, if you do ACL 3, you think this one also no need to do already. Because being from green, you already set it here. See that? Okay. Now, this one here, pink to blue, this one you have to do because it's not there yet. Now, pink to yellow, actually, you don't have to do this line also because this line is already taken care here, pink to yellow. Okay. Why? It's because you know pink is two-way. So if you cannot go here, you cannot go back also. Understand? Now, if you really think about this, you don't even have to set the fourth ACL because all the thing that you are going to set here, you see, all the thing that you are going to set here has been already part of the other ACL. So you see, blue to yellow is already taken care of here. Blue to green is already taken care of here. Blue to pink is already taken care of as well here. So in fact, there is no need for the ACL 4. Okay? So I hope that you can try this out, finish out the whole thing during your free time. At least then you can say then you should feel proud. Okay? So I think it's been quite a lot. We'll take a very long break. 10 minutes is very long to me already. Okay, so I'll see you back in 10 minutes time. I'll go get a coffee. But I think this time you'll need 2 shots of espresso at least, or 2 cups of coffee, because we are going into something even more scary, which is the extended ACL coming up right next. So see you back in 10 minutes.
Everybody's got something they had to leave behind. One regret from yesterday that just seems to grow with time. There's no use looking back, wondering how it could be now. Oh, might have been all this I know, but still I can't find ways to let you go. I never had a dream come true till the day that I found you. Even though I pretend that I moved on, you'll always be my baby. I never found the words to say. You're the one.
said one day you leave this world behind, so live the life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights that never die. Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, girl, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told child, these are the nights that never die. My father told me, these are the nights. And then the clouds start pouring down, light a fire they can't put out, carve your name into these shining stars. He said, go venture far beyond these shores, don't forsake this life of yours, I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever
still be.
Hey guys, welcome back. So right now, what you're seeing here is the last playthrough that we have maybe for the whole stream, I'm not sure, because after this one, there won't be any playthrough anymore because we are going into another part of the syllabus which is more theoretical, and that is when you can see most of people will start to disappear lah. But that's normal. So what I'm planning to do after this would be, we are not going to use packet tracer that much anymore. Still need to use them from time to time lah, but we are going to focus more on the other side where maybe we want to learn how to hack something. I don't know. Okay, I'm planning something on that. Yeah, so something that you can really take away with you after you finish this subject instead of just learning because you want to get an A in data.com, right? So I think the connection issue has been fixed 2 weeks ago. Maybe it's you, I don't know. Chat on your side. Now, I'll just quickly go through this one. What is this about? And what is the playthrough about? And then on the next week only we'll start to configure because I don't want this to stop halfway lah. Okay, yeah? It's okay, you can feel relaxed. You don't have to feel like, okay, today I don't learn enough. That's not the point, okay? Just chill. So, okay, Wong, I feel you because I've been through that for 4 weeks, okay? The problem is I'm streaming. So when I'm lag, everybody lag. When I'm digging my nose here, only 20 seconds later, only you see I'm digging my nose. So that is a big problem. Now, the next part would be, we're going to learn how to use extended ACL. And right now, this network here is a reality, okay? So before that, we have been learning with Avenger, and then we also have Disneyland. Everything is fairy tale. Everything you can find on the Disney Plus that is going to launch very soon in Malaysia. Now, that's enough. Come back to the reality, okay? Enough of fairy tale. What you see here, this example, is a real example where this is how we set up our Utah server. And some of the servers are the servers that you've been using, like Weber, your student portal, your One Utah email. And you see, this is something real. It is not really that real because this is not exactly how we do it, but something like that. So over here, you are not Prince Charming anymore, but I want you to think of yourself as a Utah admin. Okay, too bad, not GSC admin. But Utah admin also not bad lah. And yeah, you see, because now you have the power to block people from using his email. Wow, see, it really depends. This power, if it falls to the wrong hand, then it can be very dangerous. So over here, we have a few servers and 3 PC. Now, if you notice here, the name of all the PC here are all FICD students. Not FICD students, they are all Utah students. Okay, I have 3 students here that belongs to different faculty. Now, this is a bonus for you guys. For those guys who don't know what to see on Instagram, I already give you some Easter egg here, okay? So I won't go into the detail on how you configure this yet because if I stop halfway, then next week I have to repeat again. So what we are doing here is that these are all the rules that we're going to set. And on Friday, I will show you how we can do something like setting an ACL so that nobody can DOS you. And then how you can, like what you are having here right now, I'm sure when you go to Babel, you have to click on the FICT, right? If you click on FBF, then you cannot see the link to the Datacom Babel page. So something like that. So how do we actually do this? Part one of way to do this is, of course, by using VLAN. Another way is by using ACL. And I think the right way should be ACL. So on Friday, I will show you how we actually set this so that Utah students should, FICT students should only go to Weber FICT. If you are from FBF, you should only go to FBF, FBF, okay? Something like that. Hey, what happened here? Okay, never mind. So, I think we will go earlier, 15 minutes earlier this week. So, this is like a bonus. Now, if you go earlier, that means Friday, I can extend for 15 minutes late. Okay, that's a fair trade. So I think we'll stop here. Don't really have to finish the whole 2 hours. Go and take a break, have your breakfast. You can still catch MacD breakfast in this morning. So for those who waited 10 minutes just to watch me talking after the break, I'm sorry about that. So we'll continue on Friday. So if you have any questions, share it on the chat. If you don't, see you again on Friday to play this through, the last play through that we have. So until then, peace out.